In this lesson, we'll have a look at user access to the PyData Archive. But before we get into the nitty-gritty, let's have some light revision on how security works. A connection comes in to the PyData Archive, and if they've got a mapping, then they're given an identity. This is a little bit like a security badge that they can use to gain access to parts of the system. More accurately, they're usually assigned multiple identities. So in this case, they're assigned to the PyAdmin's identity and also the PyWorld identity. By default, all authenticated connections are always assigned the PyWorld identity. So after they're in, they have permission to do whatever their identities are allowed to do. This card, they can scan to do whatever they want, and they can switch it out for the other identity if they want to and see if that one works. So essentially, when we want to give them permission to do something, we have to give one of their identities permission to do it. So this PyWorld identity is really an easy way for you to configure default baseline security access for everyone. You can see these identities when you connect with client tools. So in PySMT, it's at the bottom left-hand corner of the window. It looks a little bit like this. Okay, back to what we're doing in this video. Your goal here is to set up a security model that is secure and requires very little maintenance by you, the administrator. When configuring user security, we're going to lean heavily on Windows Active Directory groups. We already know how to create mappings. We've done that for interfaces already. So creating mappings for users is essentially the same. When we created the mappings for our interfaces, we created a mapping for the svcpyint account. This account has already been created by our IT department. It's a domain account. When we configure user security, we're going to create mappings to domain groups containing the users we want to access the system. When you do this in the real world, you could leverage already created groups in your company or work with your IT department to create special groups for the Py system. We recommend creating groups for Py administrators, Py interfaces, Py users, and Py point and analysis creators. Those are really the bare minimum you'll need. Once IT has created these groups, you'll need to create mappings for them on the Py system. After you've created the mappings, your job's basically done. When a new user needs access to the Py system, they'll make an internal request to be added to one of these groups by IT and go through whatever internal processes your organization has. And after they've been through those processes, essentially IT adds them to the group and they automatically have access to the Py system. On the virtual environment we've been using so far, our IT department has already created these groups. We'll create identities and map these groups to the new identities, but we also need to talk about how to configure access for each one of these identities. Py administrators should have access to everything. The default Py admins legacy group already has this access. We're just going to leverage that. We already have our Py interfaces identity. It has no permissions explicitly given, but we have given it permission to write to specific tags. We need to remember to do that whenever we create new tags. Py users is a completely new identity we'll need to create. So we'll create it and set up the mapping to the domain group. We don't really need to create any special permissions for users either. By default, users will have read-only access to tags through the Py world identity anyway. In some situations, you'll need to create multiple different user groups and give them read access to different tags. We're not going to configure this situation right now, but it's common on a joint venture project. So if you've got a system shared by employees and contractors, and if you're doing this, you might need to set up multiple groups and give employees access to a certain set of tags and contractors access to a different set of tags. If you do something like that, then you'll need to set up these multiple identities and groups and then disable the Py world identity. Our last identity, PyPoint and Analysis Creators, is also a new identity. We're going to give this identity permission to create PyPoints. And essentially, everyone in your organization that needs to be able to create points should be assigned to this group. So right here is our security mapping as we've configured it so far in this course. We have three mappings and they all serve very specific purposes. We're going to add in the rest of the identities that we just talked about and also map them to our domain groups. So the first one is Py administrators. So this domain group already exists. We're going to take advantage of it and map it to Py admins here. So let's say new find our Windows account, well, our Windows group, click on the ellipsis, and here we've got Pi administrators. And okay on that. And the identity we would like to map it to is Pi admins. Okay, next up we have Pi interfaces. So we've already got this mapping our service account directly to the SVC Pi int identity. Let's make that a little more compliant with our model. The first thing I'm going to do is go to identities, users, and trusts, and then rename our SVC Pi int identity to match our group that we're just about to map it to. So I'm going to go into properties and then change this to Pi interfaces. Now when I go down to mappings and trusts, I see that my service account is now mapped to the identity called Pi interfaces. So I'm going to make a new mapping. This mapping is going to map the domain group Pi interfaces. Let's search for that. Okay. Now it's going to map it to the Pi identity Pi interfaces. Next up, we have Pi users. So Pi users will be a completely new identity. Let's go to identities, users, and groups. Now let's make an identity called Pi users. New identity, Pi users, and create. Now we need to go to mappings and trusts and map our domain Pi users group to this Pi users identity. So let's make a new mapping. Our Windows account will be Pi users, and our identity will be Pi users. Now, we don't need to do anything special for Pi users either. When a Pi user connects and gets authenticated, they will get the Pi World identity anyway. And Pi World already has read access to everything that the users will need. Now our last one is Pi Point and Analysis Creators. So let's make an identity for those. And we'll make a mapping. Okay, we've got our mapping, we've got our identity. Now this one will require some specific permissions. We need to give this identity permission to create points. And how we do that is we go into database security, and we give this new identity write access to the Pi Point database. So we'll double click on Pi Point, and then add in our new identity. It's going to have read-write permission, and OK. So we've created all of our new identities. Now the very last thing to do is clean up a little bit. Let's go into identities, users, and groups, and the Pi Data Archive comes with these default identities that we're not actually going to use. So I'm going to remove them one by one. Engineers, operators, and supervisors. Everything left are identities that we are actually actively using. In this lesson, we talked about how security works on the Pi Data Archive and how to apply a minimum security configuration using best practices. You can go above and beyond this, obviously, but this is really the minimum that we would recommend you set up.